Good morning, everybody. Today we'll maybe be taking the engine out of the RX8 after we take the RX8 out of the trash heap. Alright, so I think we're gonna start with just taking out the big pieces. You know, air cleaner, battery mount box, whatever this is. Get it out of the way. The best you ever had, the best you ever had is just a memory and those dreams. But as daft as they seem, as daft as they seem, my love, when you dream them all. Flicking through a little book of sex tips. Remember when the bars were all electric? And now when she told she's gonna get it, I'm guessing that she'd rather just forget it. Clinging to not getting sentimental. Said she wasn't going, but she went still. Like a gentleman had to be gentle. Was it a mecha dubber or a betting pencil? Oh, the boys are slag. The best you ever had, the best you ever had is just a memory and those dreams. But as daft as they seem, as daft as they seem, my love, when you dream them overflow. Okay, this car's been sitting so long that we literally have to peel the belt off of the pulleys. It's pretty gross.
The fact that the belt isn't deteriorating
is
kind of impressive.
All right, back to the time lapse. Laugh lane, just sounding it out, but you're not coming back again. Oh, damn it! Alright, so we got the alternator out of the way. We also devised a plan to label our bolts in bags so that 7 years from now, when we go to put this back together, the Sharpie will all be worn off and we probably won't know what goes where anyways. But if we happen to get it done within 2 or 3 years, we might know what goes where.
We'll get it done by the time the plastic biodegrades.
Check it! Father of mine, tell me where have you been? You know I just closed my eyes, my whole world disappeared. Father of mine, take me back to the day. Yeah, when I was still your golden boy, back before you went away. I remember blue skies walking the block. I loved it when you held me high. I loved to hear you talk. You would take me to the movie. You would take me to the beach. Go around. Number 9 onto the pen. Gonna keep some force on it while we're trying to move. There we go. Look at that, huh? That is a technique for the ages. Father of mine, tell me what do you see? When you look back at your wasted life and you don't see me. I was 10 years old, doing all that I could. Was it easy for me to be a scared one? Fighting with a nut. It's rusted and shitty. Got some easy outs, some good snap-on ones, but they are not present right now. Don't know where they're at, so that's the struggle. Daddy gave me a name.
gonna take like 4 hours. Thank you for the compliments on the safety glasses, by the way. I know this. Father of mine, tell me where have you been? Yeah, just close my eyes and the world disappears. Father of mine, tell me how do you sleep with the children you found and the world beside you be. Do you remember where those went, man?
Last.
You want to take a picture?
Beginning, last.
Not that we know where they go. Anyway. Yeah, you can take a picture.
You see? You look at me, you zoom in, you remember this footage, edit footage good.
Yep, it's not out.
Oh.
Oh, I love that stuff.
Ta-da!
I love that stuff.
It's so good.
Sponsor us.
I love me some mystery oil.
Back to it.
Just find a way. I'd find you every day, and we could alter time. But I've come to find everyone's gone away. So this may be the time for the perfect crime. Yes, this is perfect.
So we got a pretty good shot through the fender well here at the exhaust bolts. We got one out so far. We tried to just zing the rest of them out. Alright.
Did that snap or did it come out?
I think it came out. It's a stud though, so I have to like make like early 2000 grep and walk it out.
Now we'll see it.
I'm glad that hit one. Okay, so we get the chains through with like 4 or 5 threads on the bolt from one side, and we got this hook in place over here. We didn't have another hook, so we had to take the engine hook mount thing out of the other side. So we're just gonna position this, kind of loop it through here, and just get this roughly in position where we think we're good. Then we gotta pull out the transmission mounts underneath. We got most of the exhaust off, so we'll pull that out as soon as we get a little bit of clearance. We got most of the bolts off for the AC compressor, so that's gonna go as well. So basically we're gonna take a little bit of weight off, get underneath, set a jack up under the back of the transmission to level that out, and then work on pulling it out. I feel nothing at all. The bolts are moving, but there's... why they didn't just put bolts going into the transmission, I don't know. They got bolts going down from the top and nuts on the bottom. They're all covered in rust, so you loosen up a little bit and holding the wrench on the top and I'm bashing my knuckles against stuff every time the gun hits the thing.
Everything sucks.
That's fine.
From Harbor Freight, it's probably like $5. Heated it up enough that we were able to get one out. We got one more to go, but I'm waiting for the situation to cool down a minute. And the compressor to build up more air. Fuck!
I'll be gone for a time, tuning out for a while. It's gonna look like I'm not all there. I've decided that today seems alright to piss away. So we got it pretty much just supported by the chains right now. Engine mounts are totally out. The jack's on the transmission, and this is holding the engine and transmission right now. Pull it back a little bit and see if it moves. Can you try giving that a pull, you guys? Oh, we got some fluids coming out over here.
It feels like we're connected by some sort of something. There's a springiness to it, so.
The exhaust is still attached, so we might have to try to go up actually enough to get those bolts out of the exhaust. That's probably what it is. Okay.
Oh, motherfucker!
How did I get you? How did I get you? Were you holding the chain?
Yes!
I should realize this is hurting my arm.
It's crazy.
Yeah!
What that
label
do,
right?
I could actually say eating away the material.
Phenomenal. Thanks, man. See if we can position this more out of the way. Like so. So we got all the jack stands out. The car's at too high of an angle to be able to pull the engine out. It's just not going to work. So we got to lower the crane at the same time as the jack that's holding the car up and the jack that's holding the transmission up in order for everything to come down to a nice even pace, and then set the jack stands underneath again, pull it over.
Drive shafts out,
we're pissing all over the place though. Can I have the one of the drain pan?
Doesn't fit.
Can't get it in there. PPF's in the way, can't get the drain pan. Yeah, up and back.
Same time?
Yep.
What's the meaning?
we're hitting somewhere or something. Check all like along that side.
Stuck on. Oh. Yeah. I think that's the front that we're getting stuck on. Here, you pull it and I'm gonna watch it. Nope, nope. What are we stuck on?
Is it that?
What?
The fucking side pipe.
This end?
Yep.
Pretty stiff. Definitely don't wanna get my fingers pinched when I have that. No?
No, that's just against. Oh, bitch!
Oh.
Well, that
probably hurt.
Oh, shit, huh?
I think that was it.
Oh, man, good eye.
We are pouring out some kind of food, though.
You good, Brandon?
Yeah.
It's it, dude. This is it. It's coming out.
Vertical. We need more vertical.
Nora?
You know when to stop.
I'll let you know. Alright, pull a bit. We're stuck on something again. Is it that fucking hose again? Watch your fingers in there.
No, we're good on that.
Alright.
Might just need to keep more.
Let's go up, yeah.
I think we're looking really good right now.
Oh yeah.
Hang this on. Is it. We gotta go forward more. The transmission's hitting the car.
Forward, Mike, towards me?
Yep.
Oh.
Hang on. Can we swing this whole thing this way?
Swing wherever you want. Swing it like a wrecking ball.
We are not taking all these tires with us. I'll tell you that right now. Forward. Match. Hang on. What's that weird noise?
Sounds like something thin, so I don't curve them.
It's the exhaust thing again. Watch yourself. It's a fucking booby trap.
I got it. Where to?
I don't know. Up and out.
Up?
Let's try that.
Where?
Ooh. Yeah, I wanted it down so I could center it. Now we can go up.
Oh, okay.
So that we can go forward.
You ready? Going up.
Pull backwards. Forwards, I mean. No, hang on, hang on.
Pretty soon we're going to fall off this lip and we're not going to be able to go backwards anymore. So make sure you're in the right position.
Oh! Cheaper. Go up.
Up.
Here we go. Yo!
Keep going.
Don't trust that bolt, so be careful. All right.
Pull. Pull?
Yep.
Okay. Pull off the edge. Okay.
Hang on. Up.
Pull. Yeah, pull.
Yep. We hadn't thought past this point. This is sick. We can finally get these bolts out now. Nice and easy. All right, engine tranny came out today. Next step, I don't know when it's gonna happen, but we're gonna get the Miata over here and try to fit this in. Probably gonna use a mountless subframe, but we might see if we can just modify the subframe that's in that. In the meantime, after work on days, I'm probably just gonna start stripping all the wiring just so I've got all the plugs and everything. To be used in the future. Thinking we're gonna go with a standalone ECU to run the engine and then just a simpler wiring system to operate lights and all the BS in the Miata itself. But that's the short and simple plan. We'll see you guys eventually.
What does it, Brandon, say? See y'all next year?
See y'all next decade.
See y'all next millennium. Yeah. Robot legs kicking you in the ass.
Good work, man.